Good morning, children. Yesterday I have explained chapter 3 and the theory and the graph portion. So today we are going to start with exercise 3.1. And illustration also I have explained that is based on exercise 3.1. So let's start with exercise 3.1. So here it is. From the following data of price and demand of a commodity obtained, the regression line of demand on price also estimate the demand when price is 20 rupees. Now, price first column is of price, that is 12, 14, 15, 16, 18, and 21. And second column is of demand, that is 18, 12, 10, 8, 7, and 5. Now, see the solution. Now, here, first column is of X, that is price. Second column is of Y, that is demand, 100 units. Then we will use then we will find, first step is to find x bar and y bar. So we will find x bar, that is 16, sigma x upon n equal to 16. Then y bar, that is sigma y upon n, that is 60 upon n is 10. So now here we got x bar and y bar. Now we will go to the table again. Now we will find x minus x bar. Right? So your x bar is 16. You can use x bar method or xy method, because here digits are smaller, so you can use xy method also, right? Now, x minus x bar, that is 12 minus 16 is minus 4, 14 minus 16 is minus 2, 15 minus 16 is minus 1, 16 minus 16 is 0, 18 minus 16 is 2, 21 minus 16 is 5. Now, y minus y bar, that is 18 minus 10, here y bar is 10. See, here we got y bar 10. So here the value of y bar will be constant. Now, 18 minus 10 is 8. 12 minus 10 is 2. 10 minus 10 is 0. 8 minus 10 is minus 2. Like this, we got the values of minus 3 minus 5 y minus y bar. Now, the total of x minus x bar and y minus y bar is always 0 only. In the last chapter, in one sum, I told you that how we will come to know that it is x minus x bar or uv or sigma u, like this. So if it is given x minus x bar or x minus in place of x bar any value is given, in the last exercise we have seen like 65 or something, and its value, if any value is given, if sigma total of x minus 65 or x minus x bar, if any value is given, then we will consider it as uv, u sigma u, okay? And if the value of x minus x bar is 0, then it is considered as x minus 65 is equal to 0. Then we will consider it as x minus x bar only. Because the value of x minus x bar is always 0. Right? Now, our fourth column is x minus x bar into y minus y bar. So this is the total. This is the multiplication of third and fourth column. Minus 4 into 8 is minus 32. Minus 2 into 2 is 4. Minus 1 into 0 is 0. 0 into 2 is minus 2 is 0. 2 into minus 3 is minus 6. Minus 25. So total of sigma x minus x bar, y minus y bar is minus 67. Right? Now the column of x minus x bar, the whole square. So children, first of all, what I told you, first of all, you have to write the formula. Okay? Always write the formula first. So next column, based on the formula, our next last column is of x minus x bar. Square of third column. Minus 4 square is 16, 2, minus 2 square is 4, minus 1 square is 1, 0, 2 square is 4, 5 square is 25. So total of sigma x minus x bar is 50. Right? Now, step by step we will solve this. So here, like last chapter, only R we have to find. But here we have to find many things like B, A and our regression line. Right? What is our regression line? Y cap equal to A plus BX. So first step, in the first step we found X bar and Y bar. The second step we are going to find B. So the formula of B is the same as the formula of R. But the condition is we will make use of, in the numerator will be the same. But the denominator, in denominator we will not make, we will not write root, okay? And only x term we will use. B is sigma x minus x bar into y minus y bar under root sigma x minus x bar the whole square. This much will be the formula of B. Now we will substitute the values and we will get B equal to minus 1.34. Third step, to find A, formula of A is Y bar minus BX bar. So children, what is the value of Y bar? That is 10 minus B. Value of B is minus 1 minus is already there in the formula. Again, we will put minus in bracket minus 1.34. Don't make mistake over here. The children are putting only 1 minus. And there they are making mistakes. Then X bar is 16. So our calculation goes like this. And our value of A is 31.44. Okay. Then step 4. We have to find the regression line. What is regression line? I am telling you again and again. Regression line means Y on X. That is Y cap equal to A plus B X. That is value of A is 31.44 minus value of B is 1 point. Here plus sign is there. And our value of B is minus 1.34. So here the sign will be changed. Okay. Plus minus minus. That's why here we have a put minus sign. Minus 1.34x. Now in the question, the value of x is given. See, it is written as if x is 20 rupees, the demand will be how much? So x equal to 20. So y cap equal to 331.44 minus 1.34x. Here we will substitute the value of x. We will put 20 in place of x. Then finally our answer will be 4.64. In bracket we have to write units, that is 100 units. Okay, and we have to add. See children, you have to write units. It is compulsory to write units. If you are not writing the units, your mark will be deducted. I told you in the last video that many children got 3 children got 99, and that is also because of, I think this will be one of the reason will be this. They are not writing the units, they are not writing the statement, not writing the heading. This all makes them because of this all your marks are going. Okay, so 4.64, 100 units. See, now you will write the unit in the X column, in the Y column, whatever unit is given. We are finding Y now. So in the Y column heading, whatever unit in bracket, whatever is given, that same thing you have to put in the answer. Jada sochna nahi hai isme. The unit kya hoga? जो भी तुम्हारे वाई के कॉलम के हेडिंग में ब्रैकेट में जो भी यूनिट दिया होगा ना, वही यूनिट तुमको वाई कैप में जो आंसर आएगा उसमें सब्स्टिट्यूट करना, उसमें लगाना है. ठीक है, दैट इज 4.64 यूनिट्स. एंड आल्सो यू हैव टू एंड योर आंसर इन स्टेटमेंट. सी द स्टेटमेंट, व्हेन द प्राइस इज 20 रुपीज देन द डिमांड इज 4.64 इन ब्रैकेट 100 यूनिट्स. You have to write everything in box. You have to properly draw the lines while making these columns. Now you have to make use of pencil and scale properly. While practicing also make use of pencil. Last year also I told you when roughly you are doing that sums, at that time also you have to make use of pencil and scale. Habit ho jana chahiye. Pencil scale ka use karna hi karna hai. Simply aise aise line draw nahi karna hai. Okay? So columns should be neat and clean. Heading should be given. Then step by step, like the step 1, step 2, step 3, step 4, you have to write. After each and every x bar you found, x bar yahan mila na, uske niche likhne ka x bar equal to that box bana dena. For each and everything you have to make boxes. Highlight your answers. Here what you find in the first step, step 1 is for x bar and y bar, so make boxes. B ka value jo bhi hoga, usme box bana. Highlight karna answer. Okay. So, like this, you have to find your answer. This is the answer of first sum. Now, here the second sum. To study the relationship between the time of usage of cars and its average annual maintenance cost, the following information is obtained. First is car. Here, car is they given 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then, time of usage of a car, years X, 3, 1, 2, 2, 5, 3. Then, the annual average annual maintenance cost, that is 10, 5, 8, 7, 39, 8. Now obtain the regression line Y on X. Find an estimate of average annual maintenance cost when the usage time of a car is 5 years. And also find its error. I told you na error Y minus Y cap, that is the formula of error. See here, XY formula is used. You have seen in the question, nothing is mentioned about the method. Any formula, any method you can follow. don't make mistakes. This is full first part is coming in the last section, F section. 5 marks question. 5 marks में 4 questions है and this 4 chapters. First, second, third and fourth chapters में एक exam compulsory आएगा. F section first one from first chapter, second question from second chapter, third chapter and fourth question fourth chapter. ऐसा ही है आता है. Then next is see the solution. X column is given, Y column is given. Then we will go for our formula. Third table is XY. Multiplying the XY column. 3 into 10, 30. 1 into 5, 5. 2 into 8, 16. Like this. Now X square. X square is square of first column. 3 square 9, not 6, 9. Okay? Many students are writing 3 square 6. Jaldi jaldi mein mistakes aise hote hain. 3 square 9. 1 square 1, 2 square 4, again 2 square 4, 5 square 25, 3 square 9 only, not 6. Right? Now, sigma x square is 52. Now, first step, find mean. Second step, B. Third step, find A. And the last step is, fourth step is regression. Okay? Now, x bar is 2.67. Y bar is 8.5. And here, see. Find B and A. Note is given. Here, mean X bar and Y bar obtained in non-integers. So, we used to compute B and A by the following formula. Regression coefficient of Y on X. It is not necessary to write all these things. Whatever we are following, we can follow. This statement is not important to write. Simply, you can write step 1, X bar, Y bar. Step 2, write directly B equal to N sigma X, Y. Why the reason? No need of giving the reason. Why we have used X, Y, X bar, UV. No need of writing this explanations. Okay. So N, X, Y, N sigma X, Y minus sigma X into sigma Y upon N sigma X square minus sigma X the whole square. So here value of B is 1.93. Then step 3 to find A. So formula of A is Y bar minus B X bar. Now. Y bar 8.5 minus 1.93 into 2.67. So value of A is 3.35. Right? Now step 4, regression line Y on X, that is Y cap equal to A plus BX. Now Y cap equal to A plus BX. So value of A is 3.35 plus 1.93X. Now substitute fifth step. Substitution of the value of X in regression line, that is Y cap. So the value of X is 5. 5 years it is there. See, I will show you. See here. Obtain the regression line Y on X. Find an estimate average annual maintenance cost when the usage time of a car is 5 years. Ab pata nahi hai ki 5 years kahan hai. To table mein dekh lo. Table mein ye usage car mein diya hai. To kaun sa table hai? Hamara kaun sa column? X ka column. To ye X ka value. Okay? स्टेटमेंट लेके नहीं समझ में आया है तो ये स्टेटमेंट कहाँ आया है ढूंढ लो क्वेश्चन में कौन से टेबल में है तो एक्स के टेबल में है कि वाई के टेबल में मोस्टली एक्स का ही टेबल होता है क्योंकि एक्स का वैल्यू में सब्स्टिट्यूट करना है बिकॉज वी आर फाइंडिंग वाई कैप रिग्रेशन लाइन ऑफ वाई और एक्स वी आर फाइंडिंग दैट्स ओके नाउ वाई कैप इज 13 देन स्टेप 6 ये 6 स्टेप्स आर देयर एरर यू हैव टू फाइंड द एरर ई equals y minus y cap equal to 13 minus 30 equal to 0. So how this 13 came? What is the value of what is the value given in the question that x value 5 diya tha na? So dekho table mein dekho. Five. Na? In front of 5, what is the value of y 13? So like this we got the value of 13. Yaad rakhna ye kaise aata hai bhai. Question mein x ka value diya hoga. That is 5 is given. Hai na? Jo find karna, jo substitute karna. Last mein jo x ka value diya hota hai. Uske saamne jo bhi y ka value hai. Wo hi hum y lehen. Error mein use karne ke liye. Right? So e equal to y minus y cap. That is 13 minus 13. See yaha pe y ka y cap is 13. So 13 minus 13 equal to 0. Theek hai? This is the second question, and here the new thing is error part. Okay, now we'll see the Third question. The information for a year regarding the average rainfall and total production of a crop. Rainfall is given in centimeter. Production is given in tons. Of five district is given below. First column is average rainfall centimeter. ये सब कुछ लिखना है. Crop in bracket tons, UP bracket में दिया, जैसे दिया, as it is you have to write. Okay? Then find the regression line of production of crop on rainfall and crop if average rainfall is 35 centimeter. Okay? Now listen. Now X column is there, Y column. Then here it is. Here we have used X minus X bar method. So first step is to find x minus x, sorry, x bar and y bar. So see, what is the value of x bar? 31. Y bar is 90. Now x minus x bar, that is 25 minus 31 is minus 6. 32 minus 31 is 1. Like this, we got the total. And I told you the total of x minus x bar is always 0. If it is not 0, if here any number comes, then you can cross check because you have made some mistakes. That if it is some mistake is there, then only here any number comes. If nahi to fir hamesha yahan pe zero hi aayega. Here you can cross check your tables. Okay, kahi kahi baar cross check ho sakta hai. To ye ek jagah hai jahan par hum hamara table cross check kar sakte hain. Y minus y bar is 19. So the total of y minus y bar is 0. Ye table ka to koi kaam nahi hai, bas ye totaling ka kaam nahi hai, bas ye table mein multiplication ke liye, right? So next is x minus x bar and y minus y bar. Minus 6 into minus 6 is 36. 1 into 0 is 0. 7 into 5 is 35. Then 4, 0. So the total of x minus x bar, y minus y bar is 75. Now we will do the last column, that is x minus x bar the whole square. So the third column, square of third column. That is minus 6 square, 36, 1 square, 1, 7 square, 49 left. So the total of x minus x bar the whole square is 90. Now, see, step 1 to find mean, that is y bar x bar. Step 2, b, find b. Step 3, find a. Step 4, find regression line. Step 5, to find the substitution in the regression line. Right? X bar find ho gaya. Then step 2, b. Sigma x minus x bar into y minus y bar upon sigma x minus x bar the whole square. Value of b is 0.83. Then step 3, find a. A is y bar minus b x bar. Again and again I am repeating the formula because you will, without learning only you can, by again and again if you are hearing this, na, then only you will be, then you can come to know the formula only. No need of learning. Bar bar sunne se ye yaad ho jayega. 90 और वैसे भी बाय हार्ट नहीं करना. नो नीड ऑफ बाय हार्टिंग ऑल द फॉर्मूलाज. इफ यू आर डूइंग रेगुलरली प्रैक्टिसिंग द सम्स ना, देन योर फॉर्मूला विल बी ऑटोमेटिकली लर्न बाय यू. सो a इक्वल टू y बार माइनस b x बार, दैट इज 90 माइनस 0.83 इनटू 31, दैट इज 64.27, राइट. नाउ रिग्रेशन लाइन, दैट इज y कैप इक्वल टू a प्लस b x, दैट इज 64.27 प्लस 0.83 x. The fifth step is to estimate the value of y when x equal to 35. Question में दिया है x का value, so y cap का answer आएगा 93.32 turn. Unit लिखना जरूरी है. And the last statement is when the average rainfall x is 35 centimeter, then the production of crop is 93.32 turn. If statement is not written, then I am going to cut your 1 mark. Statement is necessary to write. Okay. So this is the your third question solution. See, the fourth question is also the same, only what we have done. We can make use of any method here also. Here one column is in next column the numbers are less than 20, and in the y column the numbers are less than 100, more than 20. So here we will go for x minus x bar method, right? A column mein chote numbers, a column mein bade numbers. एक्स वाई मेथड करोगे तो भी तुम्हारा आंसर आएगा, बट बहुत बड़े बड़े डिजिट्स आते हैं. फिर बोलोगे कि कैलसी है मैम, तो कैलसी से हो जाएगा, लेकिन तो भी मिस्टेक्स होते हैं बड़े डिजिट्स, राइट. सो दिस इज योर सॉल्यूशन ऑफ फोर्थ सम. नाउ यू हैव टू डू इट बाय योरसेल्फ. सी टुडे आई हैव डन एक्सरसाइज 3.1 फुल सम आई हैव शोन यू. And you have to solve whenever you are see that videos are coming in the channel. The same day you have to solve how much I have explained. Otherwise, your work will be pending. Please show me your this works. Whatever homework I am giving, na, if possible, send to the monitors. Or if possible, give your number, write your number and everything, and send a PDF in my email. Okay, email ID I have already given. If not given today, I will send you the email ID. Okay, so mail me, and if you are mailing, then please inform me that you have mailed that homework. Till now, from 15 to till date, 15 to 25 or 26, how many that homeworks and everything I have given, and worksheet homework which you have given, sab kuch complete karke please send me in the PDF. Today I am going to give the name of the weak students. So their PDF I actually want. जो पढ़ते हैं वो पढ़ते भी हैं. They are regularly sending me the PDF without I am asking. They are in advance. They are sending me the PDF of the works that Pooja, Nikhil, Neeraj, Namma, and all students are giving me the PDF. But few students, only this 10 or 5-10 students are only giving. So I am going to give the list of the weak students, and regularly these students have to send me the PDF. Okay. Now. This is the end of third sum and fourth sum. You have to do by yourself. This is your homework. Okay. Now, in the next period, we will start with the next exercise.